thyroid gland is right below the Adam's apple, and it's a butterfly-shaped gland. And it, as you said, it's very critical because it produces thyroid hormones, which control all the metabolic activity in our cells, so producing energy, increasing your metabolism, so very, very important.
So let's first talk about if someone is suffering from hypothyroidism. Many people don't even know that because there are so many symptoms. List some of the symptoms off.
Well, there are a lot of symptoms, but classic symptoms are fatigue. You gain weight very easily. You can be prone to depression and anxiety, joint pain, water retention. So there's a lot of just generalized symptoms people can get when they have low thyroid function.
So some of the viewers may be wanting to know what can cause low thyroid.
Sure, well, there's many different causes. First of all, studies show that just stress, prolonged stress, can cause your thyroid function to go down lower. Pregnancy, it's very common when women are pregnant, they do develop low thyroid function. But you know, the most common reason people develop hypothyroidism, it's an autoimmune condition called Hashimoto's thyroiditis. And that's basically a condition where your immune system attacks your own thyroid gland and starts to inactivate it. As well, certain medications can disrupt thyroid function. For example, birth control pills can suppress thyroid function. Cortisone and prednisone use. Some heart medications used for heart rhythm. So there are various medications which can suppress thyroid function as well. And of course, then there's nutrients. We know the thyroid gland really needs the nutrient iodine. So let's say you're avoiding table salt and you have an iodine deficiency, or in certain parts of the world where iodine isn't that common in the food supply, that can cause low thyroid function.